Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another Phorever Games drop highlight video. In this video, we will be going over 100 Mephisto runs, an offline single player with players 7 difficulty, 378% magic find. Now before I get into it, I just want to mention a few things. I have been trying to find a Shako since I started my single player runs. And I finally found one and went to pick it up, and it was ethereal. As you can imagine, I was severely disappointed and I felt a little trolled. Now you can see I'm at 5 out of 7 durability. I'm really hoping to find a non-ethereal Shako before this baby breaks. So let's get into it. On the very first run, I find a set mesh belt, and that of course is going to be Telrasha's belt. On run number 3, Mephisto drops me a unique demon hide sash, and that is String of Ears. 2 runs later, on run 5, Mephisto drops me a unique death mask, Blackhorn's face, and also a small charge, 6% magic find, a little bit of lightning. Run number 9, I almost left the game and then I decided, I might as well show it off. Got the set Bramble Myth, which is lame with hands, decent for a smiter. Run 14, we get the unique tiara, and that of course is Kira's Guardian. Run 17, we get another pair of laying of hands. That massive damage to demons is why it's so decent with your increased attack rating. On run number 18, we get the lovely teleporting staff, Naj's Puzzler. Run 20, we get a pair of the unique light gauntlets. Great for casters, Mage Fists. On run 24, Mephisto decides to drop me the first unique amulet of the runs. Of course, we're looking for Mara's Kaleidoscope. And also the unique Balrog Spear. The amulet turns out to be Mahim Oak, no surprise, and the Demon's Arch of the Balrog Spear. On run 28, no way. Mephisto did it. Only 28 runs in. I get the unique Shako and it's not ethereal. He also blesses me with a 40% magic find Eads. Nice little cherry on top. And there she is. Thank you, Mephisto. On run 30, we get the unique gauntlets. And those are Frostburns. Decent if you're struggling with mana. Do a little switcheroo with my tones. On run 34, we get this rare circlet, which turns out to be a half-decent fire sorcerer's circlet with the run walk and the resistances and life. On run 36, we get our first set amulet. Cybers. No surprise. On run 45, we get the unique mesh armor. Unfortunately, it's not ethereal. On run 49, we get Varanar's Star, and also another of the ever-so-prevalent set death mask.
Impossible.
Which, as you know, is Talrasha's mask. On run 54, we find another set amulet. Really hoping for Talrasha's amulet. Still haven't found one. It's Tancred's. On run 58, we get a couple decent drops. Got the IK Maul and the unique Ornate Plate. And it's not ethereal, unfortunately. Would have been great for a merc. Nonetheless. On run 62, we get the unique Grave Wand. And That is Black Hand Key. On run 65, you dog. He dropped us another unique Shako. Also not ethereal. Can't complain about that. On run 66, the very next run, ooh, Eldritch Orb. And I get trolled. It's ethereal. Not only is it ethereal, really poor roll. On run 75, we get the unique Bone Wand. And that is Graven Spine. Decent for low level Necro. Two runs later, on run 77, we get the infamous Chansey's Chance Guard, Magic Fine Gloves. On run 83, Mephisto drops us our first unique Ring of the Rocks. Can it be a Soge? That would be an excellent bonus. And unfortunately, it's Dwarf Star. On run 84, another unique ring. Looks like Mephisto wants to propose to me too. That's a negative. On run 94, to end this set of runs, a Thresher. And it's ethereal. Great weapon for a mercenary. Definitely gonna hold on to that. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I'm really excited about my Shako. I'm gonna be getting it isted. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Peace.